Listowel, 10th of May 1920, National School during the War of Independence, an Irish language revival. Main points to note are the National School plant collections of May 1920 and in February 1922 that Irish names were used. This is a plaque from the old school on the side wall. Note, National School. It was later that it became a boys' school. This is from the Folklore Commission. The National School in Listowel was built in the year 1836. It is a two-storied limestone building. The site for the school was given by Lord Listowel. The upper floor of the school was reached by means of a stone staircase protected by an iron railing. The upper story was used as a girls' school and the lower story was used as a boys' school. When the nuns came to Listowel, they built a school and the girls went to it. The upper story was then used as a boys' school and the lower story was used as a storeroom. The earliest records date back to the year 1856. And the principal teacher of that time was a man named Mr. O'Callaghan. In 1869, the floor of the lower school was boarded. The money for this purpose was at a bequest of Mr. Humphrey O'Connor. The lower school was used as a junior school and the principal was a man named Mr. Lawler. In this Ordnance Survey map of 1919, we see the National School on the left, the graveyard, and then the sports field and St. Michael's College. This is Upper Chess Street in 2021. The Bay School is just above the white car on the right. It's called Railton the Moderner, was built in 1960, replacing the old National School. And actually, Frank Shee, the principal of the senior school, lived in the house near the white car. This is the front or street side of the school in the 1890s. This is the east side of the school in 1953. Number one is Pat Welch. 7 is Moriarty, 11 is Lines, 18 is M. Gallivan, 30 is Jackie Reedy, 37 is Sean Guerin. Note the badges, note the little shed over on the left, and this is actually taken at the east side of Brian McMahon's classroom. I left the National School in 1958. This is my sketch as I remember the school. The main entrance was at the rear and it also housed the stairs to the upper floor. On the ground floor, you left this area of the main entrance into a corridor which took you down to Mrs. Griffin, then Mrs. Crowley. I think Michael Caine was next and then Brian McMahon at the end. Now he had his own separate entrance. He also had his own little tuff shed and the toilets were out on the street side near the main gate, and the playing field then continued up to the graveyard and there was a continuous row of trees. On the upper floor, when you reached the top, again a little corridor. And down at the end, on the left of my sketch, you had a gallery, which I can remember Dick Flaherty being there. Next was Frank Sheehy, who was the principal of the senior school. And I think Joe Flaherty and Dick Flaherty were in the next room. Now, this is the main purpose of my presentation, which is the plant collection of May the 10th, 1920 to the 24th. And listed is Earthnut by J. Keefe in the Woods, Lilac J. O'Sullivan in Wrights, Dockleaf D. Sullivan in Ismore, B. Bugle, I think, W. B. Han, Riverbank, Mountain Ash, J. Keith Wood, Hound's Tongue, D. Sullivan, Innes Moore, Laburnum, A. Malone, Armstrong Wood, Yellow Broom, J. Sullivan Drummond, Ground Ivy, D. Sullivan Drumlucra, Comfrey, J. Griffin, Ballybunnan Road, Milkwort Blue, D. Sullivan, Innes Moore, Yellow Rattle, J. Griffin, Crockettosan, Pink, D. Sullivan, Innes Moore Bog, Yellow Rocket, N. Crowley, Brennan's Field, Bramble, J. Griffin, Market Cliff, Hot Trefile, M. Enright, Market Cliff, Water Crowfoot, J. Griffin, River, Herb Robert, T. Filarty, Glasha, Wall Peltoria, E. Nolan, School Wall, Sycamore, D. Hennessy, Gutenart, Water Speedwell, C. Nolan, O'Connors, Sharlock, D. Hennessy, Sweetmans, Scorpion Grass, P. Kennelly, Riverbank, Bog Cotton, E. Filarty, Shrone Bog, and Birdsfoot, C. Nolan, the Cannon's Field. These are photos taken on Sunday the 5th of May this year along the River Field Walk. It would be a nice project for schools to replicate the school collection of 101 years ago. This is the school weather chart for November 1920, and it was in this month that the gymnasium in the sports field was burned down by the Tans because it was used for the speaking and learning of Irish. Listed amongst the functions of the gymnasium were dances organised by the hockey club, ladies club, O'Shaughnessy's club, Tennis Club, Bachelor's Club, Harrier Club, Badminton Club, Volunteers, Camogie Club, Terrier Coastal Club. Concerts were promoted by the Town Clock Fund, Fuel Fund, Temperance Society, Altar Society, Confraternity, and assorted items such as dancing lessons and various pictures. Company showed movies there. Charges for the hall were ranged from 5 shillings to £1. The equipment of the hall was nothing if not extensive, including, as it did, horizontal bar, parallel bars, dumbbells, trapeze, ropes and hooks, trapeze bar, punching ball, vaulting horse, springboard, ring apparatus, boxing gloves and ropes. The instructor at the hall was World War veteran Jack Summers. Irish language revival in 1900. The Kerry Sentinel on Wednesday the 21st of November 1900, page 4. Heading was Irish Language Revival, Enthusiastic Public Meeting in Listowel, Speeches by Mr. Flavin and O'Donnell MPs. On Friday night, a large and thoroughly representative public meeting was held in the hall of St. Patrick's Total Abstinence Society in Listowel, in support of the Irish Language Revival movement. Addresses were delivered by Messrs. M. J. Flavin, T. O'Donnell MPs, J. O'Gallagher Tralee and others. Unfortunately, an unfriendly government has done all that's in them laid to bury beyond hope of resurrection. He thanked God, the spirit of the Irish people, as well as the spirit of the Irish people, has not been killed. They were a symbol to give their little assistance to push forward the Gaelic language by every means in their power. And he said that the language, being the language of Ireland, was a language well worthy of support. And they could not expect that the Irish people would be worthy of their ancestors unless the language that had been handed down had been preserved by them. St. Patrick's Hall was built in 1894 as a temperance hall. They had their own band, hence it was called the band's room also. The volunteers used it quite a lot from 1916 to 18. For the opening of the Sportsville in 1960, the Artian Bice Band entertained us in the store. On the same day, there's myself, Michael Guerin, Joe Guerin, Ty Leahy, John O'Brien, and I'm not sure of the others. This is outside Lynch's, Buckley's, Welch's, now the Tanker's Pub. Number 2 is Mary Buckley, 4 Gerald McElligott, who's now a teacher. 5 is Kathleen McElligott, Nee Kennelly of the Cloth Hall. We see Rillihan's and the Saddle Pub above these. This is the first Carnegie Library in the Bridge Road, burnt by the Tans on the 7th of March 1921. Brian McMahon learned Irish here according to his book, The Master. This is a notice that appeared in the Kerryman in 1915 about the late Mr. James Guerin. James Guerin was a noted Clan Leach activist and also a fluent Irish speaker and a member of the Listowel Gaelic League. We can see that his chief mourners were Mrs. Cotter, his daughter, Dinis Guerin, and Devereux. Now this is the plant collection from the 27th of February 1922 to the 15th of March. We have the Daisy by T. Chute from Eldersfield, Dandelion by M. Feely, the Small Inch, Celandine by J. Feely, the Riverbank, Laurel Nobility by J. J. Carroll, the Square, Primrose by E. O'Brien Cahardown, also from Primrose from from T. Chute, the Workhouse, Daffodil by J. Foley Woodford, Speedwell, E. Gleason School Wall, Furs C. Mulvihill Cleavra, Groundsel M. Griffin Greenville, Grassflower from J. Sheehan at the Schoolyard, Borage from W. Dinehy Cannon's Field, Cabbage from J. Sweeney, the Plots, Periwinkle, E. O'Brien Cahardown, Wallflower from M. Griffin Convent Street, Dead Nickel, T. Lawler, Cannon's Field, Willow White, J. Horrigan, Innismore, Hazel, P. Hannon, Ballygrinnan, Violet Sweet, E. O'Brien Cahardown, Shepherd's Purse, M. Griffin Workhouse, Saki Fresh, T. Lawler, Market Wall, Ellen from J. Sweeney, Gortinard, Fiery Thorn, M. Griffin, Kilmorna, Black Thorn, J. Hannon, Ballygrinnan. During the Civil War, Republicans' honorary tree burnt the workhouse in late July 1922. This shows a cover of the book The Listowel Workhouse Shunan that I wrote in 1996. Please add any further information, names or corrections in the comments.